Teresa Earnhardt refuses to go away, but some things might be changing. Welcome back to Break Hard. My name is Matt, and yes, the Wicked Witch of the Southeast is back in the news again. Well, we're kind of putting her in the news, and it has to do with the trademarks she has for the former DEI numbers. So Joey Tartamella on Twitter, apologies if I butchered his last name, does a fantastic job of keeping track of where the trademark process is at, especially with DEI and Teresa Earnhardt. And some interesting things are happening. So Teresa and DEI let the number 15 trademark lapse, and Michael Waltrip was able to swoop in, snag that for his Michael Waltrip Brewing, and now he owns that. Now, Teresa still has the 8 and the number 1 trademarks down. And when you look at the trademark office's website, some interesting things are happening here. So the status currently on the number 1 trademark is that it is in process. And you can go through and look at the documents. And there's been a decent back and forth between the trademark office and DEI, Teresa Earnhardt, and their lawyers about, you know, proof that this trademark is being used. And they've gone back and revised it multiple times, removing certain things like license plate, you know, holders, keychains, things like that. They went ahead and just crossed off shirts and sweatshirts. So they need proof that there are items being sold here. And remember, DEI hasn't been around for a while now. So what merch are they selling? It seems to be up in the air, and that's where the dispute comes into play at. But that trademark is in the process of being renewed, which is interesting. We'll get to that in a second on maybe why she's so steadfast on making sure that this one is renewed. But the number 8, the one that really everybody cares about, that's where it gets really interesting, because as it currently stands, it's not in the renewal process. And in the same spot where it says status, and when you look at the number 1 of what was Steve Park, but if you look at that number 1, it says maintenance filings have been received and reviewed by the post-registration team in due course. So it's an ongoing process here. But when you look at the number 8 car for its status, it says latest date that can be filed paying an additional fee, June 3rd, 2024, a very quickly approaching date, under a month away from now. That trademark has not been submitted for renewal yet. And as of June 3rd, that's the last date that it can be up for renewal. She has to pay an additional fee, which I'm sure she does not care about if she wants to. But if you're going to begin this renewal process, you would have done it months ago, back when you did the number 1. And now this could be her just absolutely teasing everybody, because I feel like this, if there's one person that loves to hold a grudge outside of Dave Portnoy, it might be Teresa Earnhardt, because of her fallout with Dale Jr., with Ty Norris, and everything that went down at DEI. Her waiting until June 2nd or June 3rd to file that renewal just to be like, haha, you thought you were going to get it? Nope, double bird like Will Power, could be in play here. At the same time, maybe she's just going to let it lapse. Maybe she will let it lapse and Dale Jr. or RCR or somebody can swoop in and take that trademark away. Now, I can't imagine that's going to happen, especially after the fallout when Dale Jr. left the team at the end of 2007, and the two seemingly haven't spoken since and don't have a relationship at all based on what Dale Jr. said on his podcast. I can't believe she's about to let that just lapse and him take over for it. At the same time, maybe she is. Maybe this is the olive branch for the Earnhardt family, for Dale Jr., Kelly, and that side, to be like, here, you can have this. Use it on your cars if you want to. You can have it to sell the merch, which that would be really interesting in itself. Because right now, if you go to the NASCAR Classics hauler, there's not Dale Jr. merch there to be had like there is everybody else. And you could make a small fortune off of selling Dale Earnhardt Jr. merchandise still with that number 8 on it. I mean, obviously, it's famous number 8, especially with the Budweiser on the side. So maybe she is going to let it lapse. And maybe Dale Earnhardt Jr. is going to go ahead and swoop in. But the fact that it hasn't been started for renewal yet is very interesting. And we'll have to wait until June 3rd to see what happens there. Why is she so steadfast on renewing the number 1? I think this might be, this is purely hypothetical, purely me speculating. I think it might be some deep-rooted resentment for Ty Norris. So Ty Norris is over at Trackhouse right now. Trackhouse, of course, fields the number 1 and the number 99. Trackhouse and Teresa Earnhardt had a go-around in 2022 when the Trackhouse cars were running those Coca-Cola throwbacks for the Darlington Throwback Weekend. And they were presented with a cease and desist to stop using the number one on the side of that car because it was essentially what DEI did. So Trackhouse went ahead and just put a little slash through the one. Now it's theirs. It's a different intellectual property, different design, everything like that. So they were able to continue to use it. I think what she wants to do here is just still prevent them from doing any sort of throwbacks, from ever having the number one available to them to do anything with it, to ever be able to, capitalize monetarily off of that number. I think she just does not like Ty Norris. And as long as she can hold on to that, she absolutely will. Because outside of that, there's really no reason to hold on to the number one. It wasn't the most famous number at DEI. Steve Park drove it. Daryl Waltrip drove it for, a hot second. Jamie McMurray was in that car when it was that weird blend of Earnhardt Ganassi. And I just don't think that there's really that need to hold on to it. Because what merch are you selling? Obviously, there's still going to be some number one merch that's sitting around, but if you're not making new merch for it, then what's kind of the purpose of holding on to it? So it's interesting to see how this is going to play out. I'm sure Joey will keep us all, aware of the situation on social. But for her to have not filed that patent or that trademark yet for renewal is, that's the most interesting part to me. And again, I can't believe she's going to let it lapse, but maybe she will. This is coming, a month and a half, after 2 months ago when it was announced that Carowinds would not be having the Intimidator name this year on their roller coaster, instead naming it something ridiculous like Project 305 or something like that. And because I couldn't come to an agreement with Teresa and the DEI, team of lawyers that were, trying to represent the trademark and licensing agreement there. So maybe she's just getting out of it. Maybe she's done capitalizing on it. She made all the money she wants. They're selling a lot of Earnhardt merch at that Classics trailer. So maybe that's what it is. Maybe she has a soft spot in her heart now. People say you get kinder with age, maybe, up until a certain point, then you become grumpy once again. And maybe that's what's happening. Maybe she just kind of realizes that she wants to move on from it. Either way, if that 8 number becomes available, that trademark becomes available, there's going to be a number of Dale Jr. throwbacks. Dale Jr. is probably going to get that. Get ready for all the merch to be out there for everything. But for now, things might be in play. And I think that's really interesting. So guess we'll find out when we get to June. Let me know in the comments what you think about it. Like and subscribe to the channel. Follow me on TikTok @BreakHard, Instagram and Twitter @BreakHardBlog.